Міжнародного Торонського кінофестивалю ТИФ чланові управи українського фестивалю у Blue West Village Максиму Столяревському вдалося намовити режисера Євгенія Афінєвського на відкриттю свого фільму на фестивалі вбрати на себе майку на підтримку українського режисера політв'язнення Олега Сенцова. Це викликало великий розголос на соціальних мережах світу. Після цього режисер Євгеній Афінєвський зустрінувся з представниками складових організацій Торонського відділу КУК.
Tonight we're extremely happy to have two guests. Those of you who maybe don't read the internet or just completely living in a box, Winter on Fire is a film that's being shown at TIFF, and we're very excited by that as a community. I know it's been very well received. We have first of all Yevheny Afinyevsky, did I pronounce it correctly?
Yeah.
The director, and Dan Tolmer, producer. Okay, so welcome to both of you. Nice to have you here.
It's something that was there. It's something that we try to create as the chronological story that needs to be told to the generations. Something that needs to be seen by the government in order to remind them that at the end of the day, the power is the people. And governments can't betray their trust. So I think it's a great reminder for the current government and for the future and for some other governments all over the world. And besides that, I think another great message that can be taught for the young generation, I think the real role models that should young generation took, it's the characters that we have in the movie. All of a sudden he called me, and what he's saying to me, Evgeny, you need to come down. The history happening here, the history being made. You need to be here. You need to do Maidan through the eyes of people who came out, and they're not political. And
I'll tell you a few words about that guy. I mean, I was calling him and said, you know, it happening. It happened right now, you have to come. And he said, for how long? I said, probably 1-2 weeks max. And he was staying there for 6 months. So that's how a movie made. And that, I mean, he did an amazing job. And the point is, when we started, we all, you know, we started with a small group, like two cameras and, you know, the director and some administration. But at the very end, we had like 28 people who was documenting and, you know, voluntarily give us the footage. That was the amazing job. From my experience, it was just first time. The people did that, you know, in front of the violence, in front of the very, very heavy weather. It was minus 20 degrees Celsius, something like that. And they were sharing whatever they have because they need to bring the subject to the crowd.
You know that technically Maidan changed the world. These 93 days in a history became a 93 days of the changing points of the world. Because before, United States, Russia, Europe, Ukraine, everybody had their lives. And 93 days of Maidan, even if we're starting to go on the 10th of December, when European Union, US ambassador, who was there, Nuland, Ashton, all of them trying to resolve this peacefully with Yanukovych, same time Yanukovych sending Berkut to the square to clean the square. So here we go. So all communities around, all world tried already to be involved already in December, and look what's happening then. Maidan winning. Maidan won for me. This was the chapter of the history that I think need to be mentioned. Maidan won. The people, their unity, achieved everything. Remember that. At the end of the day, all these lives that we are given, all the situation that happens in Maidan, the situation that never happens across the globe, unity of all nationalities, unity of all social groups, unity between all churches, remember that. We never saw in any countries that church, who usually the instrument, or political instrument, the government's usually using church to brainstorm the people. Here, all churches open their doors for the people. Where you saw that leaders of every confession on one stage staying and supporting people without implementing religion. Now, I'm a Jewish guy, and I will tell you something. I was flying there. A lot of friends of mine from Russia was telling me, you Jewish guy, you go into different country where a lot of anti-Shemite happening. And you know what? I never saw this. I had a lot of friends there before. I've been a lot in Kyiv. Then it was before in Kyiv. We have a lot of friends. And you know what? Being on Maidan, I know Nathan Hazin, who was the Jewish Sotnia. And I asked Hazin a couple of times. I said, hey, have you felt something? Because I not. And he said, Evgeny, look at my Sotnia. I have like tons of people from different nationalities. So this is unity that really won. Something that is a great sample. Again, this is the message of this movie, unity. I wish Middle East can live by the same rules between Jews and Muslims that was on a square. So this is the amazing things that happened there. My BlackBerry was literally hacked from the first days when I started to talk to Ruslana and Mustafa. I do got calls from FSB because I was born in Russia. And again, it can be another story like this for me if I will be close to the Russian soil. I trying to stay as much far from all the situation because I do want to be able to tell the story of Maidan maximum. My personal, basically what I personally asking all of you guys, vote for the movie because I do want to teach and knowledge that it's a favorite of the audience, and I do want to bring this story to more and more and more homes across the globe. Actually, we have amazing relationship with Netflix that bringing this on the 9th of October across the globe in over 50 countries, 65 million people. Since it's gonna be playing on Netflix for, let's say, next 3, 4, 5, 6 years, and by end 2006, Netflix will be having all other countries, adding like almost every country in the globe, including Ukraine and including Russia. So we're trying to do maximum right now, and Netflix is doing their best to bring attention to all the awards, Hollywood awards and everything. That's why, for me, important to try to get something from Toronto right now and to show that this is the favorite movie.
To all pass on a thank you to all those who were on the Maidan and who took brave shots in some cases as people were getting shot around them. They continued to film, which was brought the story to life, so they deserve a huge thank you from behalf of the world and from us to you for doing the movie. You two gentlemen are bringing a great service to this cause, and we want to thank you and wish you further success. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming out so much.